GTM Podcast Vidura The Wise Episode 5 Hello everyone. You are listening to GTM Podcast, the continuing mini-series of Buddha's stories. Here we listen to stories of the lost Buddha's past lives to gain a deeper understanding of Buddhist wisdom. In this series of podcast, we will learn the lessons of Vidura, the wise, the man who excels in truthfulness perfection. Before we start, if you have not listened to any of the previous episodes just yet, we suggest you go back listen to them for more understanding on the background story and characters. Please also help us by subscribe, like and share our podcast to support us and help continue the program. Now that we all are set, let us continue with our story. From the last episode, after meditating in the park on the full moon night, the four kings left their places of solitude and met each other unexpectedly. They warmly greeted each other and found a suitable place to discuss the Dhamma. King Sakka began, "All of us have observed the eight precepts, but have you ever wondered whose moral conduct is the greatest?" The Naga King declared, "Surely my moral conduct is the greatest. Garuda is the Naga arch enemy. He attacked and killed us. Yet, I have no fear or anger toward him. My moral conduct is the greatest." The Garuda King boasts, "Normally, Naga makes a splendid meal, but I have stopped myself from killing this Naga King. Therefore, my moral conduct is the greatest." King Sakka proclaimed, "I rule the Tavatinsakruyam, the second level of heaven, where I am surrounded day and night by beautiful female celestial beings. Yet, I have come to the human realm to practice meditation and observe the eight precepts. So my moral conduct is the greatest." After a few moments, King Dhananjaya spoke, "I left abandoned wealth and beautiful courtesans to practice meditation alone in this park. I understand that material wealth can cause problems and unhappiness. I briefly left it all for the sake of solitude. Therefore, I believe that my moral conduct is just as great as that of everyone here." Then he added, "A decent person who knows the harm of those objects and physical craving and choose to abandon them is said to have just purpose and is at peace with the world." They continue to argue, each king citing the excellent deeds that caused him to be more outstanding than the others. In the end, they could not agree to whose moral conduct was the most exemplary. The three visitors then asked King Dhananjaya, "Well, good friend, in your kingdom, is there a great and just sage who can resolve this matter for us?" "Indeed, there is," King Dhananjaya answered with pride. "His name is Vidura, the wise, and he is the sage of the court. He is highly respected and admired by all of the kings on the continent." The three kings said in unison, "Why are we still here? Let's go meet this great sage so that he can resolve this issue for us." And the four kings left the park. When all the four kings arrived at the Dhamma hall, King Dhananjaya requested the bench to be decorated and sent someone to summon Vidura the wise. When the sage arrived, he was invited to sit on the adorned bench. After the kings and the sage exchanged greetings, they asked, Honorable wise and truthful sage, we had a discussion concerning whose moral conduct was the greatest. We ask that you resolve our dispute and present us with an enlightened answer. It is a known practice that sages listen to and consider all information concerning an issue or dispute from those involved before pronouncing a judgment. Vidura, the wise, said, Your Majesty, what discussion did you have about moral conduct? Please provide me with the details. King Dhananjaya spoke. The Naga king said that, since he was not angry at the person who deserved it, his moral conduct was the greatest. The Garuda king said he refused to commit the misdeed of killing for the sake of the meal. King Sakka said that he left all five sensual pleasures to keep the precepts in the human realm. And I said that I was willing to leave my great wealth to practice meditation. We would like to know whose moral conduct is the greatest. After King Dhananjaya's explanation, Vidura the wise now understands the king's dispute. Will the sage know how to resolve the matter? Will his judgment please the four kings? The story continues in the next episode of Vidura, the Wise, the Man Who Excels in Truthfulness Perfection. Please subscribe, like, and share our podcast with family and friends. Until next time.